Lesson 3D, Using the Draw Tool in the National Map Viewer. The National Map Viewer is a primary access point for the visualization of geospatial data that composes the national map and functions as a tool to enable the use of data in a web environment. This video is part of a series of short lessons that provide the user with an overview and demonstration of some of the more advanced functions of the National Map Viewer, including how to add data, draw on the map, drive elevations and profiles, and print maps. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to use the draw tool to add data and measure distances in the National Map Viewer. The next lesson demonstrates how to select data from the map and take actions on it. The National Map Viewer serves as a window into freely available base map data that is consistent on a national level and provides resources to access the data through a variety of products and services. To access the viewer, launch a web browser and navigate to the link shown. For help at any time, click the Link to Help hyperlink. The Draw Tool button is located at the top right of the viewer and looks like an artist's palette with paintbrush. Click on it to enter drawing mode. This opens the draw window that offers a number of drawing modes from points to lines to various types of polygons. A text option is also available. Let's select the point option. Once the drawing mode is selected, additional controls will appear in the window. For points, options include choosing a set of symbols and selecting a symbol size, color, transparency, outline color, and outline width. The actual number of options varies depending on which symbol is selected. Many have only the size option. To see the available symbol sets, click on the down arrow below the symbol preview. A list of symbol sets will open with the current set in bold. Click on the set you wish to use. When you click on the specific symbol, only the available options for the symbol will be displayed. When the campsite symbol is selected, all options but the size disappear. Also note that there are more symbols available in each set than fits in the display window. A slide bar allows you to scroll through the entire set. Change the size of the symbol with the up and down arrows to the right of the symbol size. Notice the symbol preview changes to the size selected. To place a symbol on the map, simply click at the desired location for placement. You can also add your own symbols to the map. Scroll to the bottom of the list of symbol sets and click on Custom Image. For best results, your symbol should be 16 by 16 pixels, but other sizes will automatically be adjusted. Supported image formats include PNG, GIF, and JPEG. The measurement tool demonstrated in Lesson 3B measures distances on the map only in straight lines. You can use the draw tool to do more precise measurements on nonlinear structures. This comes in handy when you want to measure the distance along roads or trails in mountainous areas. Select the freehand polyline from the drawing modes. At the bottom of the options, check the Show Measurements box and use the associated drop-down menu to select the units of measure. Trace the feature to be measured by holding down the left mouse button and tracing. Release the mouse button to stop tracing and see the results. Areas and perimeters can be measured using other drawing modes. Let's add some text to the map. Click on the Draw Mode button labeled with a capital A. Type the text you wish to be entered into the text box below the Drawing Mode buttons. You can also change the font size and text color using the control boxes below the text box. Click on the map where you wish to add the text and it will appear. To remove your drawing and text from the map, click Clear. In this lesson, we discussed how to add data by using the Draw tool in the National Map Viewer. Additional lessons will demonstrate other advanced tools available within the National Map Viewer.